All right. What seed do you have inside of you that's just waiting to sprout up? I know it's in you. I know it's in me. Do you think we're stifling that sprouting of that seed with our thoughts? And why do you think that is? That it's easy for us to get up every morning, we brush our teeth before we leave the house, we brush our teeth before we go to bed at night. Well, we do that because we know that if we don't, that eventually our teeth will just rot out of our heads, and that's not going to be a good thing because it's going to cause other issues, bad breath, inability to eat, a really crappy smile, among other things of which I have no idea, but I instinctively know that I would rather not find out. So I brush my teeth. And yet we don't take care of our thoughts in the same way. I heard something last weekend and it stuck with me. I heard, I am the thinker that thinks the thoughts that creates the thing. I am the thinker that creates the thought that creates the thing. I believe that we think the thought, it goes somewhere and then it comes back to us as our experience. So if we walk around believing that life is hard, that work is hard, that relationships are hard, guess what? It comes back as our experience. Maybe it will come back in the form that there isn't enough money at the end of the paycheck. Or you work with people at the office who are difficult and moody. Or maybe it comes back to us with a diagnosis and a not so good prognosis. The seed that we have in us that wants to come up through the ground and sprout, guess what? It is unstoppable. I do believe that. So today, let's celebrate our magnificence and our radiance. Scream it to people. I am radiant. I'm going to share with you something that I learned just through things I listen to and books that I read, something that has stuck with me, and I just love it. And I think this is the best way to express your radiance. Yes, I said radiance. It's a way of figuring out why you're here. So I think we've all asked that question. Why am I here? What is my purpose? Each of us has our own why, and it's unique. So let's go on a little journey, shall we? Let's take a step toward figuring out why you are here. So take just a moment to think about what your why is. What is the first thing that pops into your head? If that why is more than one word, guess what? That's not your why. That is your what. Your why, if your why is to have a close-knit family or to make a ton of money, if your why was to change the world, those are all incredible, but they aren't your why. The woman I heard this from says that that's your what. That's how you express your why. And I apologize, I don't remember her name that I got this little exercise from. So I certainly cannot take credit for this. But it is one of those things that I heard and I haven't forgotten because I do love it. So you have your why. Whatever that is, imagine that the resources to do whatever it is that you want to do to express your why is readily available to you. You want to raise amazing kids. Guess what? The resources for the best schools, the best coaches, the best foods to feed them, resources for the very best of neighborhoods to grow up in, all of that is available. You want to change the world and give fresh water to communities all over the world. Boom, you have $5 million once a month to go out and have fresh water given to the world. And you can just readily go out and do that, no problem. So now we're gonna go even further. And you're 112 kajillion years old, 87 or 92, whatever. You are older than dirt and you are lying in your bed and you know that this is it and it's time. And with this next breath, you're heading out to your next great adventure. And you look up at the people who are around your bed and they are the people that have loved you best. They are the people whose lives that you have helped change over the years. They are all there. And as you take that last breath to move through your journey, what do you feel? Peace, joy, love. There's an emotion. That word, whatever that word is, that is your why. That is why you have come here at this point in time to show up. That is the unique thing and the way in which you contribute to the universe. And once you know that why, that is what you focus on. Write it on your bathroom mirror. Put it on your dashboard in your car. Put it on your computer screen. Put it on your phone screen. As long as you focus on your why, she says that life will open up in front of you. And I believe that because I've tried this and it has opened up. But sometimes I go back. So when you're feeling frustrated or sad, I guarantee that it's time to stop and just reassess, because then you know you're not focusing on your why. And I'm in that process right now of reassessing. So I know. This sounds really great. You know your purpose, you're embracing, celebrating your radiance, but it doesn't get rid of all the crappy human stuff in our lives, does it? It doesn't turn those detrimental relationships into supporting ones. You know, look how that person changed for me. Oh my God. It doesn't change a bank account that may be nearing a zero balance. Here's one you can relate to. It doesn't change those billable hours that are slipping under budget. And all the emails that you've sent out offering up assistance aren't bringing any work. And fear is starting to set in. All the stories from our past that have convinced us to live small haven't disappeared, have they? So what do we do with the physical details that we're facing? We're going to address that next week. But for now, we're going to have just a very short affirmative meditation, very short. So we all know, and we've heard many times, that it all begins with us. How easy it is to be tempted into wanting someone else to change for us. If they change, then there will be peace and I'll be happy. The only thing we can really control are our own thoughts and our own hearts. So this is an opportunity to just sit in the quiet for just a few moments without words, and to just go inside and change the concept we have of ourselves. To see ourselves as a blessing to the world when maybe we don't feel that way at all. What would we do? How would we act? How would we speak if we fully believed and looked in the mirror and saw ourselves as a blessing to the world? That is my invitation to you today, to open your eyes and see all of the abundance already in your life, to see all the good around you right now, to live in that awareness, to live in that peace, and to push any fear out of your sight. We aren't meant to struggle. Life isn't meant to be hard. Enjoy your moments, this moment. This moment is your life. If you're slow at work today, do what you can do to manage that. Send out the email, unclutter your desk, and get ready for more work while you binge watch Netflix. So do what you can, and then just enjoy the downtime without worry or fear, because the work is coming. If you're dealing with someone who is difficult at the office, just remember that when people are being difficult, oftentimes they're more likely coming from a place of fear themselves. So let's find our peace today, because at the end of the day, isn't that really all that matters? Go be amazing and do that happy dance. Happy Friday.